Classification of material on the basis of resistivity. So the material can be classified as conductor, semiconductor, and insulator, and depending upon their resistivities. So an ideal conductor, it has zero resistivity or infinite conductivity. They both are. If it is infinite resistivity, that means it has zero conductivity. For ideal conductor, zero resistivity and infinite conductivity. While the ideal insulator, they have finite resistivity, that is zero conductivity. So metal, they have low resistivity, that is from 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter to 10 to the power minus 6 ohm meter. And at the other end, our insulator, like the ceramic, like rubber, the plastic, they have resistivity 10 to the power 18 times greater than the metals. It may be more than that. But semiconductor is somewhere in between these two. So they have resistivity characteristically decreasing with the rise of temperature, and the resistivity of semiconductors, they are also affected by if you have some impurities in it. So it is generally found that good conductors of electricity, like the metals, these are also good conductor of heat. Superconductor are the exception, while the bad conductor of electricity, like ceramic and plastic, they are also found to be the bad conductors of heat. Resistors which are used in lab, there are two types, wire bound resistors and carbon resistors. So wire bound resistors, these are made by winding the wires of alloy, that is manganin, constantan, nichrome, or similar ones on a proper base. The resistivity of these materials, they do not change appreciably with the temperature. While the carbon resistor, which is another resistor type used in laboratories, the carbon resistors are widely used in electronic circuit like the radios, television, and amplifier. So the carbon resistor, they have very small dimension and is very inexpensive, right? To make a carbon resistor, pure graphite is mixed with resin, which is molded into a cylinder at high temperature and pressure. This wire leads, the ends are attached to two ends of a cylinder, and the entire resistor is insulated in a insulating jacket made up of ceramic or plastic. So carbon resistors are available in the range from 1 ohm to 100. M is mega ohm. Color code of carbon resistor. So the value of carbon resistor is found from the color bands, which is marked on the surface of the cylinder of the carbon resistor. This is an example. So let us take the resistor and color code, and we'll see how to understand this. So the color of first band on the resistor shows its value in tens. The color of the second band shows its value in units. The digit for different colors, we'll just see. If you see, it is in the figure. So the third band will imply what? It implies the number found by the first and second digit, and it is to be multiplied by 10 to the power n. So the multiplier 10 to the power n for different colors are given here in the color codes. So the fourth color band shows the possible deviation, which is the tolerance, if you see here, in the value of resistor. So we have different colors, they are different colors. So all these different colors, and this is the digit 1, this is digit 2, this is the multiplier, and this is the tolerance. So let me tell you again, the color codes are something like this. The first is the digit 1, second is the digit 2, the third is the multiplier 10 to the power n, and this one is the tolerance. Okay, for example, if red is there, this color is red, so the tolerance will be plus minus 2%. If this is, say, yellow, so it will be 10 to the power into 10 to the power 4. So this is like what we have to compute. So we'll take an example. Okay, if you see this figure, the first band on the resistor is yellow. This is yellow. And the digit of this color is, see, what is see here carefully, it is yellow. So the number is 4. For yellow, the number is 4. The second band is violet. Violet. And the corresponding digit is what? See, violet. What is the corresponding digit? It is 7. So we write 7. So the number formed due to the combination of these two digits is 47. And the third color band is orange. If you see, this is orange. Now the orange, let us see what is in front of orange. The multiplier is 10 to the power 3. This is multiplier. So now we multiply it by 10 to the power 3. 10 to the power 3 is kilo, so it is 47 kilo ohm. The last color band is golden. So let us see golden, which is plus minus 5%. So which is indicating the value of resistor calculated above can have a variation of 5%. So we write plus minus 5%. So the value of resistor is 47 kilo ohm plus minus 5%. This is how we, because of the color code, we can find out the value of the resistor.